Last night?
No. Drank far too much.
Far too much, huh? Were you there too, Bradley?
I was.
You were, huh?
We were well over the legal limit.
Well over the legal limit, huh? Well, I'm glad somebody else was driving.
They were.
And you made it safe?
We did.
Are you going to have fun today?
I hope so.
Are you excited?
He will.
Very.
Well, you don't look nervous.
Very.
Very nervous?
That's it.
You're happy, though?
Yeah.
All right. Have fun, you guys.
Will do. Thank you.
Just a little bit closer. Yeah. Okay, shake hands. Look this way.
That used car salesman.
Carl, I'm honored to have his.
Look this way, look this way.
Not too far.
Bring your up front, yeah.
This is all Brad's.
I have one more picture. You have a watch on? With the what?
Dana, are you nervous?
Not yet. It'll happen when I see Brad.
Brad's here.
I know. I saw him out the window.
Well, you're not supposed to look. You look beautiful.
Thank you.
Donna, this is your conscience. You really want to get married.
It's too late now, Dan.
That's right.
Oh, it's dead. I thought it was a conscience.
Good luck.
Thank you. Are you going to see it?
Yeah.
Okay.
Thank you.
entered into unadvisedly or lightly, but reverently, discreetly, and soberly into this holy estate that you have now come to be united. Who gives this woman in marriage? The ceremony of marriage in which you have come to be united is the oldest ceremony in all the world, celebrated in the beginning in the presence of God. Marriage is a gift from God, given to comfort the sorrows of life and to magnify life's joys. Marriage is also the clasping of hands, the blending of hearts, the uniting of two lives into one. Your marriage will stand not by the power of the state, nor by the seal on your marriage certificate, but rather by the strength of your love and the power of your faith in each other and in God. Bradley, wilt thou have done it to be your wedded wife, to live together after God's ordinance in a state of holy matrimony? Wilt thou love her, comfort her, honor and keep her in sickness and in health, and forsaking all others, keep thee only unto her for as long as your Lord shall live? Donna, wilt thou have Bradley to be your wedded husband, to live together after God's ordinance in the state of holy matrimony? Wilt thou love him, comfort him, honor and keep him in sickness and in health, and forsaking all others, keep thee only unto him for as long as you both shall live? Will everyone here today, witnessing these promises, do all in your power to support this couple in their marriage? Please say, we will.
We will.
You have come here today to be united as husband and wife and you have joined hands. Please look at each other now and repeat after me. I, Bradley, take thee, Donna, to be my wedded wife.
To be my wedded wife.
To have and to hold,
to have and hold
from this day forward,
from this day forward,
for better for worse,
for better for worse,
for richer for poor,
for richer for poor,
in sickness and in health,
in sickness and in health,
to love and to cherish,
to love and to cherish,
till death do us part,
till death do us part.
As God is my witness,
as God is my witness,
this is my promise,
this is my promise.
I, Donna, take thee, Bradley,
to be my wedded husband,
to have and to hold from this day forward, for better, for worse, for richer, for poorer, in sickness and in health, to love and to cherish till death do us part. As God is my witness, this is my promise. The scripture chosen today is from the 1 Corinthians chapter 13, verses 4 through 8, telling us what love is like. Love is patient and kind. It is not jealous nor boastful. It is not arrogant. Love is not rude. Love does not insist on its own way. Love is not irritable nor resentful. Love does not rejoice in the wrongs, but rejoices in the right. Love bears all things, believes all things, hopes all things, and endures all things. Your love will never fail you. Of harmony, of unity, of oneness. circles, your rings have no beginning and no ending, and they are really tokens of the relationship that you have come here today to celebrate. Bradley, please take down his ring. Place it on your ring finger and repeat after me. With this ring, I thee wed.
I thee wed.
Donna, to Bradley. Place it on his ring and repeat after me. With this ring, I thee wed. Let's pray. Dear God, Creator and Father of us all, we thank you for the gift of marriage and for the joys that come to us in marriage and for the blessings of home and family. Today especially, we think of Bradley and Donna as they begin their new life together as husband and wife. We ask you, Father, to give them the strength to keep the vows that they have made, that they may cherish the love they share, and that they will be faithful and devoted to each other all the days of their lives. Amen. Those whom God has joined together, let no man put asunder, for as much as you have come before us and before God and have expressed your desire to be husband and wife, you've shown your love and affection by the joining of hands. You've made promises of faith and devotion to each other, and you've sealed these promises with the giving and receiving of rings. By the power vested in me by the state of Michigan, I now pronounce that you are husband and wife. Amen.
Thank you.
Now please join me in the Lord's Prayer. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory forever. Amen. And now if you will turn and greet your guests.
Yeah, you can leave it out here, and I'm not just going to back out, but yeah.
smile. Come on. Father and son. Okay. There is no love in single brothers and sisters on the side of the room?
No. This.
No bedroom.
Mr. and Mrs.
Okay.
There you go.
Hello, we made it!
Here we go.
Thank you. Here I am at work.
How are you?
Oh, don't ask me.
Pen don't work, naturally.
At all times.
First natural.
Well, that's work.
There we go.
Let me get it.
Better.
Thank you for the Easter card. I can send you Easter cards.
Hi, everybody.
How you doing?
Did you have a good time?
Oh yes, wonderful time.
You're both looking very beautiful and handsome tonight.
Thank you.
We'll catch you later.
Okay.
Yeah, just don't walk out the door with me.
Get sloshed right now.
That's right.
We're allowed to get sloshed.
We're not getting sloshed. No.
Socially loose.
Socially loose.
Socially loose.
For what did you want everybody
on? See you next week, huh?
Okay, next week.
Did you have a good time?
We just got here.
All right, we'll see you later.
Have fun. Bye.
Who, me?
Yeah,
I'm getting a Bloody Mary and a pitcher of beer.
What, to wash the Bloody Mary down?
Well, yeah. A pitcher of beer would be a chaser.
You can have some fun then.
I better.
All right, thank you.
You're welcome.
How's it going, Donna?
Good.
You having fun?
Love it. Excuse me.
Beautiful. It's gorgeous.
Oh, pretty. Do they have a long tray?
Yeah, it's all tucked up now.
I'm going to check with them up there to see if they can go to
Mark will help you.
Hi, Mark.
Terry, how are you?
Here you go.
Now that's a two-fisted drinker there, isn't it? You weren't lying, were you?
I wasn't lying. I got my chaser right here.
All right, party.
What can I get for you?
Scotch and water. Fuzzy navel and a screwdriver.
Well, then walk on over. Walk
Hi.
On over. Are you having a good time?
Yep.
Isn't it beautiful?
Time. Congratulations.
Can I get for
you? All right. Have a good time.
Mother.
Brad, Donna, wish you the very best. We hope that you find the same happiness that Richard and I have found. And Tina Murphy, that's a nice wedding. Thanks for inviting us.
It's scary over here.
He really is.
Well, that's like the screen. Do you actually know?
Yeah.
Turn around again.
What do you say?
Congratulations.
All right.
To Mr. and Mrs. Bradley Arthur Heifel, may their love endure forever.
Yes.
I'd like to thank everyone for coming on behalf of Brad and Donna Heifel. And everyone have a good time. Drink what you like, but remember you got a long ride home. So be very careful or have designated drivers. So here's Mr. Frank up here.
Father Frank.
Let's just bow our head. Raise before me. Bless us, O Lord, and these I guess. Which we are about to receive from thy bounty through Christ, our Lord. Amen. Enjoy your meal.
Short and sweet.
Bless you.
Yes, we love you.
Bless you.
They were ready to breathe.
But this
fantastic party. Successful. How about you?
I think it was very successful.
I think so as well.
Great dinner, wasn't it?
It was.
Yes. It
was. Are you
going to
dance right away? Or?
We have two more pictures, table. And then we'll be dancing our feet off.
I saw that.
All right. If you need me, have
a My hands smell. I should call them up.
Albany.
the bride, Frank and Audrey Polarowski. The girl's mother and stepfather, Helen Warren. And Gary Arbogold.
Goodbye, Nana. Goodbye.
And the groom's father, stepmother, Ryan Heipel and Vicki Heipel. Nice Glenn Miller tune called Moonlight Serenade. And everyone is welcome to dance.
Here we go. Happy life together. I love you, Brad.